Hallo, dieses Video ist für meine sechste Klasse, Unit 9b. Ja, das Thema ist immer noch Ferien, Freizeit und wir können jetzt beginnen. Wir können starten auch. The pages we have, the pages ist also die Seite 56, 57 in eurem Kursbuch und Seite 62, 63 in eurem Arbeitsbuch. So, of course, we use the same book like always. Deutsch.com from Huber. Please buy it. I try to add the link in the description, so buy it because of copyright reason. And let's start. Okay. Erste Aufgabe. Aufgabe Nummer 1. Lest den Titel und schaut die Bilder und schaut euch die Fotos an. Denkt nach, was wisst ihr schon über diese Jugendlichen? So, read the titles and look at the pictures. So, think about what you already know about the students. Okay, so have a guess. So, what do you know already? Next one. Schaut die Fotos an. Wie ist die richtige Reihenfolge? Notiert sie. Okay, so look at the picture. What is the correct order? Okay. The first one they give you already. Okay. 11 o'clock, already so late, and oh, and still in bed. Okay. So, this is this one. So organize these sentences accordingly to the pictures. So just read the sentences and look at the pictures. Pause the video now and yeah. Okay, so ding dong is quite is the sound very easy. It's of course the door, yeah? E. Ding Dong, die Freunde von Basti an der Tür. There's some mistake. There's a verb missing. Sind. Maybe. I would add a sind. Ah, so die Freunde von Basti sind an der Tür. Next one. Next sentence ist wirklich müde, endlich fertig. So, very tired, finally finished. So here they still look happy here at the end, no? So I would say it's D. Alle helfen, wer macht was? Everyone helps. Who is doing what? No? Wer ist who? Macht ist doing and was ist what? And this is of course C. No? So they sit here. No? You can see everything is still dirty. So later we can talk about the story. And the last one is of course E. Cola für alle. Cola und Chips für alle. Ja. Gut. So, let's talk about the story. So there's two ways we could think of this, you know. I would think that he sleeps very late because yesterday they had a party, you know. Then his friends come because yesterday is a party, so his flat is dirty, so they want to come and help to clean up. So here still everything is dirty. Then they clean up and afterwards they get drinks and chips. Okay, this is one way to look at this, but of course you can also think they're a very messy person. So he sleeps late, his friends come over. Then they get chips and cola and things like this. Everything is dirty, and then they clean up. But I'm pretty sure it's other way around. Okay, so this would be the answer: B A D C E. Okay. So now is a audio text. Hören. Wer macht was? Kreuzen Sie an. So here is the flat. So you have to listen. Here activity: Die Wohnung aufräumen, das Geschirr abspülen, die Mülleimer ausleeren, im Supermarkt einkaufen, Cola und Chips mitbringen. Okay? So, Nummer 1 ist die Wohnung aufräumen, clean up the flat. Das Geschirr abspülen, clean the dishes. Ja? Na, you can also see the picture. Die Mülltonnen einmal ausleeren, empty the trash cans. Im Supermarkt einkaufen, go to supermarkt and buy stuff. Ja? Cola und Chips mitbringen, get chips. Okay, so I have to activate. Where is it? I have to activate the audio. There. Activate the audio. Okay. So please listen and make a cross if you get it right.
Lektion 9. B3. Teil 1.
Hallo.
Hi, Bastian.
Ihr seid schon da?
Wie? Du stehst aber spät auf.
Oh, sorry. Ich bin immer noch so müde von gestern.
Ach, komm.
Also gut, ich mache hier eine Liste. Wer räumt die Wohnung mit mir auf? Bea, machst du das?
Na sicher, Bastian.
Und ich spüle ab.
Super, Marc, danke. Und wer leert die Mülleimer aus?
Ich kann das machen.
Super, Juliane, danke. Leider haben wir fast keine Getränke mehr. Maike und Peter, kauft ihr bitte im Supermarkt ein?
Na klar.
Also, ich wiederhole. Bea und ich, wir räumen auf. Marc spült das Geschirr ab. Juliane leert die Mülleimer aus. Maike und Peter kaufen ein. Ist das in Ordnung so?
Endlich fertig.
Boah, ich bin müde.
Ich hole Cola für euch. Darf ich, Bastian?
Na klar. Bea, bringst du bitte auch noch Chips mit?
Gerne.
Okay, if you didn't get it by now, then you can go back and yeah, listen to it again. Okay, so I solve it now with you. So let's make an X. So at the beginning, Basti say, "Wer räumt mit mir?" With myself. So Basti and Bea clean up the flat. Mark spült ab. Mark spült das Geschirr ab. Also Bea und Basti räumen die Wohnung auf. Marc spült das Geschirr ab. Die Mülleimer ausleeren. Juliane. Also Juliane leert die Mülleimer aus. Maike und Peter einkaufen. Und das letzte ist, wer bringt Cola? Bea. Also, Bea bringt Cola und Chips mit. Gut. Now, so, this is how you find this in the dictionary, ne? So, aufräumen, abspielen, auslernen, einkaufen, mitbringen. But I taught you already, so they're separable verbs. So, this is how you find in the dictionary, aufräumen, einkaufen, abspielen, aufstehen, mitbringen, auslernen. But this is the sentence how to use it, ne? Also du stehst aber spät auf, ne? So aufstehen, okay? So aufstehen, let's change the pen. Aufstehen is of course here. Okay, you have auf, you have stehen, aufstehen. Okay, so now what I want you to do, pause the video and then look at the verbs. Remember the verbs is, if you have separate verbs, second position, last position, except if you have a question. If you have a question like a yes or no question, then verb first position, verb last position. Okay, so I make it easy for you. You have always two verbs because they're separable. Okay. Okay, I think this is nearly too easy. Not nearly, it is too easy, no? So aufräumen, cancel this, you know, let's use the small pen. Aufstehen, aufräumen, abspülen, einkaufen, ausleeren, mitbringen. Gut. Important for me here is what I want you to do beside is this verbs here. Find out the conjugation. Okay, so go to the internet, Google them, and conjugate them. Okay? Good. Yeah, here again. So here's again what I explained to you just a few seconds ago. Aussage wie Fragen. Okay? Aussage Fragen wie Fragen. So wie Fragen means W question. Wie Fragen. Wer, was? Ne? Zum Beispiel, was trinkst du? So if it's a wie Frage, then of course the verb is position 2. Okay? Why? Because the W is in position 1. So there's no place for the verb, so it has to be position 2. Now we have yes and no question, okay? So again, what did I say about yes and no question? Can I have a look? Correct. So yes and no question, verb first position. Okay? You can see here. Okay? And then trennbare Verben, Präfix. Where is the prefix? The prefix is always at the end. Here. Okay, so you don't have to think so long about this. If you see a verb, remember I show you the a list. If you see the specific verb, so what happened is here is the cat, no? Cut, 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 cut. So what you do is you put this first position to the end. First position to the end. Good. What else we have here? Wortakzent. Ah, okay. Wortakzent. We can listen to it. So you read the verbs, and then we talk about this.
Lektion 9, B7.
Aufstehen. Abspülen. Aufräumen. Ausleeren. Einkaufen. Mitbringen.
Okay, so in class. I can also open the video. One second. Display teaching. Oh, I didn't have my camera. So you can also clap this, you know. So aufstehen, there are three syllables. So the first one, this is German language. Most of the words in German have a strong pronunciation at the beginning and a weak pronunciation at the end. If it's a German word, zum Beispiel auf, aufstehen. Okay, so the emphasis is on auf. Why? Because we also have the verb stehen. Okay, stehen, auf. Okay, so now why your emphasis on the auf is because to show the difference, you know. So German is a language of contrast, so we emphasis on the auf. Why I cannot draw on it? Yeah, we emphasis on the auf. Because we want to show the difference. Because stehen means to stand, aufstehen means to get up. So in order to show the difference, that's why we highlight on the front. Good. So now we have a messy room here. So you have to make sentences, okay? So Bastian, Mark, Maike, Peter, Bastian, Bea, Lena und Bea. So they are all the subjects, remember? So I normally make subjects green. Don't save it like this. Check. So normally I make the subjects green. Then you have the verbs, huh? So you can first highlight the things. Huh? So then you have the verbs. Verbs normally is purple in my case. Remember from my lesson. Where's purple? This more or less, huh? Like a dirty purple. Okay. And then we have time, we can make orange. So when? Only one timepiece. And then location. Im Supermarkt is a location. And then we have the direct object. Okay, so how to find out these? Okay, so the first question is, if you want to have the green one, wer, you can ask wer. So who is, no? Next one for the orange is wann. Wo, was. Okay, so here again, I make it colorful for you. Yeah, I cannot draw on top of this circle, so bad. So wer is who? Wann is when? Wo is where? And then was is what? So this is how you find out the sentence pieces, okay? So now I want that you write sentences. You have a table, remember, in which order you have to put them. You always start with the subject if it's a statement. So pause the video now and go. Good. So now you have two choices. You can either make an ich perspective. So here, like in the example, they use an ich perspective. Or you just make sentences like Bastian steht um 10 Uhr auf. Something like this, you know? So, do you want the ich perspective or you describe him? Good. Next one. Hier ist ein Dialog. Wer kauft ein? Ich mache das. Wann kommst du mit? Anna, kommst du mit? Na gut. Spielst du das Geschirr ab? Carmen. Nein, ich bin zu müde. So here and again. Here is the statements. Na klar. Na gut. Nein, ich bin zu müde. So, na klar. So a very happy smile. Of course, you like to help. Na ja, gut. So it's like, oh, okay, I do it. Und nein, ich bin zu müde. No, I'm too tired. Okay, so you can ask each other. Yeah? If you would be in class. Good. And then it's the first paper already gone. So we go to our workbook. Of course, again, we use the Hubert Arbeitsbuch and then Seite 62, 63. Okay. The first thing is you have here adjective. Okay. So you have to rearrange the words. Okay, so pause the video and do it now. Okay. So let's make that easy. Cool. Doof. Okay. Toll. Interessant. Did I just make it backwards? No. Unweilig. Boring. Hässlich. Ugly. And the opposite is schön. Pretty. Nett. Nice. Okay. What else we have? Can you see it? Okay. Lustig ist funny. Nee. Easy, ne? Super. Awesome. Do you see it? I actually want to see if Google can already find it out, if you wrote it wrong. No. Okay, I leave this for you. Too easy. Okay, so now here we have a dialogue tree again. So again, first have a look here. Okay, so Geschenk für Stefan, Idee, question mark, nicht kennen, Uhr, then sad smiley face, Pullover, sad smiley face, Sims Spiel, happy smiley face, and Hoffe. Okay, so you automatically know, ich hoffe is the last piece. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 pieces. So this must be number 9, huh? Automatically, okay? So try first by yourself. Okay. I hope you're finished. So now you just search for the word keys, huh? So nicht kennen. Kenne nie nicht, ne? So nicht kennen. Eine Uhr, 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 Uhr. Gut, keine Uhr, vielleicht ein Pullover. Keine Uhr, wo ist Uhr? Cool, oder? Wie findest du eine Uhr hier? Ne? So, if this is the question. Now the answer, she don't like it. Gut, keine Uhr, no watch. Ne? Then, what else we have? Pullover, so question for Pullover. Where's the pullover? Wait. Set smiley face. Oh, wait, sorry. This one is it. Ich finde sie hässlich. Finde ich sie hässlich, ist die Uhr. So, Nummer 5 ist das. So. Okay, I was one ahead. So Pullover, now again. So Pullover is male. And again, I want to show you one thing. So why no, Uhr is feminine. So here, die Uhr. Ich finde sie hässlich. Okay, so now he asked for den Pullover. Ich finde ihn langweilig. I find him boring. Okay, so that's why I know what is automatically next, which negative she choose. Okay. So, na Sims-Spiel, Nummer 7. Und dann 8. Good, this would be the answer. Perfect. So now here, you have to write your own dialogue. Okay, so again, use this dialogue as an example. Okay, you have to find out the article, but everything else you can copy-paste. Good. Try. Dann. Nummer 14. Was passt, kreuzen Sie an. Okay? So, what you can use? Again, start first by yourself. So, you have the verbs aufstehen, einkaufen, abspülen, aufräumen, mitbringen, auslernen. So, get up, buy, clean the dishes, clean the flat, or clean. Der abspülen is for dishes, with water. Aufräumen is more like tidy up. Mitbringen is to bring with, and auslernen is to empty. Okay, you can just make a cross. Okay. So what do you can use it? So let's start at the back. Cola und Chips einkaufen, of course, you can buy them. Okay. You could also mitbringen. Yeah. ausleeren, you could throw away the cola, ne? Or open the bag and put it out. And then aufräumen, you could also, if there's chips on the floor and cola on the floor, you can also tidy it up. So this is possible. So what else? Im Supermarkt. Im Supermarkt einkaufen. If you are rich, ausleeren, okay. Aufräumen, you could also tidy up the supermarket if you work there. Now das Geschirr, you can buy it, you can clean it, and you can bring it. Yeah. Good. Mülleimer. Mülleimer, you could definitely buy a rubbish bin. You could empty in. You can bring a rubbish bin. You can actually, if it's very dirty, you can also wash it with water. But let's make like the main one. The main one is this one. This one. This one. This one. This one. Okay. The last one, die Wohnung. Die Wohnung. Aufräumen. Ausleeren, if you move away. But the main one would be this one. So most people would use always the orange. So the orange X is the main purpose, okay? Spät aufstehen, okay? You could do all of them could be late, no? You could do buy in late, you could clean the dishes late, you could aufräumen late, so up to you. But then you have to add it zu, huh? Also zum Beispiel zu spät einkaufen, the supermarket is already closed, zu spät abspülen, yeah? Okay. So now you have separable verbs here, so organize this verbs here to the gaps. Pause the video, try it now. Good. Then of course we have einkaufen, chip is here, räumen, aufräumen here, and ausleeren, bringen, mitbringen, and then auf, good. Next page, oh yeah, so much, okay. Here, they tell you already how to start the sentences. Okay. So this is a question, so here. So try to write sentences. Pause the video, write sentences. Good. Then let's start. Remember separable verbs. So the first thing actually you can do, if you're already lazy, the first thing for all of them, this is the last one you could already write at the end of the sentence. So you know it's the last word, so this a highlight in orange you could already put at the end without thinking. Ich stehe nicht gerne auf. I don't like to stand up. Bringt er die bringt er zur Party die Spiele mit? Okay. Dann okay, so this will be the order. Wer spült ab? Ich stehe nicht gerne auf. Bringt er zur Party die Spiele mit? Thilo leert oft die Mülleimer aus. Wann kaufen Ingo und Markus ein? Wir räumen morgen auf. Gut. Genau hier, trennbare Verben, schreibt die Fragen. So, you have the answer here. You have to write a question for this. Okay? And they already tell you what they want to know. You just have to pay attention to the underline one. The underline one they want to know. Okay? Remember here, her ding. Here the question. Wer, wann, wo, was? So if it's a person, you use wer. If this the kursiv is a time, you use wann. If the kursiv is a location, you use wo. And if the things is an object, then was. For example, supermarkt is location. So you replace supermarkt with wo. Wo kauft er ein? Karin is a person, so wer leert die Mülleimer aus? Question mark. Morgen is time. Wann spülst du ab? When do you clean? Ne? So, aufräumen, so now the verb. Verb is also. But, was macht Carlos? What is he doing? If you search for the verb, if you want to know the verb, you use was macht. Next. Getränke. You can ask what. Okay? Manchmal bringe ich Getränke mit. Was bringst du manchmal mit? Last one, nein, Karin lernt sie aus. Okay, yes and no. If you see there's a nein, then as the first thing you know is a yes and no question. So you start with a verb. Zum Beispiel, leere ich die Mülleimer aus? Do I have to clean the rubbish bin? No, Karin lernt sie aus. Gut. Next one. Ordnen zu ergänzen. Ja, so, fill in the blanks. Okay, so, we have something positive. The first one is positive, so she likes it very much. So, the first one is... Na klar. Tada. Hi, ich bin es. Geht doch nicht in die Disco. Okay? I don't go. Negative. Ich bin müde. The last one is... Na gut. Gut. Last one. Finde 6 Feste. Festivals. Okay? We can talk about this in a class, but try to find 6 festivals. And then the last one here is you have numbers and organize them. So I don't help you with this one. This we make maybe in class, but you of course have to fill it in. Good. This is all. Bye bye.